Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. From coast to coast and all the ships at sea, welcome to Backline. Oh, Jesus, why do you keep doing that? Why can't I sit here? Yes, this is Backline. This is where we tell a lot of stories. Lawrence, stop. You know Lawrence, right? Lawrence. You know, there's only a couple types of people that are named Lawrence. That's sailors and some of the guys from Boys Town in Chicago. And I don't see a sailor suit on you. But he's a nice guy. See, Lawrence is okay. He's okay. Okay. For some reason, Lawrence wants me to move. Okay, fine. He's a director today, so we will move somewhere else. Okay. All right. We'll be back, ladies and gentlemen. What? Oh, you ready? Okay, thanks, Lawrence. Good evening, boys and girls. Okay, let's cover some news here. I'd like to know if this big man Tyrone is still president of Kekistan. Basically, I don't care if he is or not. It doesn't mean anything to me. Another thing is the Sargon of Northern Kekistan and Mrs. Sargon of Northern Kekistan just had their third child. They have now three of each. Congratulations. Don't worry, that tail falls off after a while. So, no problem there. And what else? Oh, jokes. You want me to tell some jokes, some stories, or some shit like this? Okay, let's tell some bar jokes. A guy walks into a bar, and he's got a pelican on his head. Bartender says, "Where'd you pick that up at?" Pelican says, "Outside." Drum roll, no drum roll. Okay. Okay, there's another bar. There's a bar on 106th and Ewing Avenue. Troublesome bar. A lot of people got hurt there. A lot of people walked into that bar and were seriously injured. And the people in the neighborhood kept calling the city up to have the bar, removed. And, it was just a lot of trouble. Anytime you walked into that bar, you got hurt. So finally, the city came out and cut down that 6-foot-high iron bar from the neighborhood. So, speaking of bars, I walked into this bar. Jeremy, let me tell you something. Did you ever notice how much hotter right-wing chicks are than left-wing chicks? You ever notice that? Ever notice how cuter conservative chicks are than liberal slugs? I mean, some of these chicks on the left are just, they're disgusting. And I walked into this bar. I sat down next to this chick. She was older, a little stringy hair and everything. Her face didn't look too bad. I thought if she cleaned up her act, she wouldn't be so bad. So I said to her, lady, if you cleaned up your act a little bit and bought some feminine hygiene products, you might be a nice looking chick. Wait a minute, that was my wife. Oh, I'm sorry, that was my wife I was talking to. I'm sorry. I get confused. I've had five wives. Two of them were actually mine. So, moving on. I was walking down the street the other day and a bum comes up to me and says, "Hey, Bobby Rizzo, can I have a couple bucks for a sandwich?" I said, "Well, let me see the sandwich." So the other day, too, my brother-in-law comes walking up to me. She says, "Hey, Bobby, lend me $5. Nikki, why don't you get a job?" He says, "Well, that's your job." That's my job. Okay, never mind. You know what? Before I forget, too, John Pepe has a report on Russian ghost signals somewhere in Russia, evidently. And he's gonna tell you about that. Oh yeah, too, before I forget, John Pepe just got promoted. He's no longer Private Pepe. He is now Private First Class Pepe. At community college paid off, didn't it? Okay. Is there sandwiches left over there? Oh, in the kitchen? Okay, never mind. Captain Sombodi, we sent him over to the border of Turkestan and Turkmenistan and Kekistan near Mengelstan. I don't need these fucking Polak names. Mengelstan, and that's where he was ambushed and got injured. And so we probably have a report on him too, see how he's doing. Yeah, I don't know much about these ghosts, whatever they are anyway. But seems like John Pepe knows a little bit about it, so we're going to check into that. And just one other thing I want to say is, You people on the right don't realize that you are at war. The Democrats, the left, the liberals, the socialists, they're at war. And they're at war with you, and they know it too. You guys don't understand it. This isn't your America. Remember you had years ago, you had an America that was like, you know, pretty cool. You don't have that now. You have two Americas. It's like the Civil War. It's going to be a Civil War. But the people on the right, they just, I'm sorry, they just don't get it. I just don't understand it. So, well, anyway, let's send it over to John Pepe right now. He's going to talk to you about this Russian ghost signals and where they come from and what we could do about it. Evidently, we could do something about it, but I don't really know. So, anyway, John Pepe, you over there? There he is. Pepe first class now, right? Is that what it is? All right, back to over there to John Pepe. Thanks, I'll talk to you guys later.
I don't know, I wanted to see what you guys maybe think of this, because I can't figure this out for the likes of me. I've been trying to pinpoint it, but they keep changing the station, but the frequency's always the same. That's the weird thing. Like, I'll have to, like, here, I'll nothing but static until I'm right about. There it is.
Nico, guys. Anna, Ivan, Mikhail, Ivan, Nikolai, Anna, Семерка, Четверка, Единица.
Isn't that weird? I thought it was absolutely strange as hell. It's got to be some, I don't know, I've heard about a Cold War ghost station that the Soviets used to use or something, but it's not possible. I think I debunked years ago.
Anyway, a few days ago, my brave signal intelligence guys managed to get an info file. Thank God they've finally put us in place. Anyway, for what it reads as something Russians, or I don't know, Russian termites or some shit, planted a vehicle in, what the fuck? That's a fuck my fucking name.
Whew. Oh, I was outside and I got this breaking news thing. There's some Turkmenistans or Russians or communists or something trying to break into our southeastern border of Kekistan. We got some patrols out there also. Here's some footage coming in now. We seem to be holding them pretty well here. We've got a good team down there. A lot of firing going on, it seems like. Speaking of teams, I also have some footage of Captain Sombodi's rescue. There was a SEAL team out of Kekistan that went down there and located him and brought him and his team back. I recognize some of those guys too. That's Wyndham Earl right there, and Tyler Durden. Here's Tyler Durden right there too. So that was a good team too that went down there. So we're going to bust in with breaking news as much as we can here. We want to keep you on top of things. So here's some more footage of our Ukraine and Polish outfits there in the trenches holding back the, seem to be Russians, I would think, or Turkmenistan, or Mangolistan? Mangolistan? What were you telling me? Mangolistan? I wouldn't keep on top of this. I'm going to head out right now. You're using gas? Well, I'm not a general. There's nothing I can do about this. They're using fucking gas down there. You know, you're going to kill a lot of people, and plus you're going to kill our plants down there, too. You know, we got the melange, and we got all the spices and shit. This is not going to look good for us on the world stage here, people. Kekistan using gas on people, although they're fucking communist Russians.
It's musty.
Battalion of the Prussians that they used, the 2nd Battalion Prussians. They're kind of a fanatic group anyway, so keep our boys away from this. Try to bury the story too, if somehow. Whew. Act like Democrats and just lie. That's all. Just lie about this. Say it didn't happen. I gotta go see somebody. This is, yeah, nothing I can do about it. Jesus Christ. Okay, I know I got a little excited. They got a little bit into politics. I wanted to get more into Captain Sombodi. We got people looking into that. I showed you a little clips of our SEAL team that went down there and rescued him. He's doing okay now. We got to find out what's going on at that border there. And John Pepe is kind of confusing me with this Russian signal thing. I can't grab it. I don't know what this is. He's looking into it. We're sending troops down there. That's probably why the Russians or the Turkmenistans or the Mengel stands or something are trying to close that border off. See, that border down there is not quite going eastward. It's not quite Kekistan, and it's not fully Turkmenistan. Almost a neutral zone between us and Russia. So we can go down there, not as a military expedition, but we can go down there and look around, pick some flowers, do shit, whatever like that, plant a little marijuana, whatever we want to do down there. We have some saffron fields, and we got some melange fields down there. That's our spice. We got some fields down there, and we go back in there. But now being attacked at that border, it sounds kind of fishy. We have to look into that. So I'm going to keep on top of this, and we'll pick it up in Chronicle 11. So for right now, you take care now.